The National Football League welcomes you to the Pepsi Super Bowl 56 Halftime Show.
Grammys, 19 number one Billboard albums, and 5 legendary artists on the biggest stage in Los Angeles.
Absolute superstars all coming together. And at the top of it is one of the greatest producers of all time.
Huge moment for hip hop. These people weren't supposed to make it out of where they come from. For them to be some of the biggest icons the world has ever seen, it will go down in history forever.
And when you listen to the music, when you listen to the hits back to back to back to back, you can't help but feel a certain weight.
Don't get it twisted. We are literally fitting a music show in the middle of a football game.
Due to the size of the set, this is tremendously more ground cover than we've ever put out before.
How do you build something in 8 minutes and take it down in 6 and still make it something that people will never forget? We're gonna make history. This is gonna be the greatest halftime show ever. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right, here we go. Yo! Let's go from the top, man. How you feeling?
Good.
All right, cool.
My name is Adam Blackstone, and I am the musical director of this year's Pepsi Super Bowl halftime show. I am in charge of everything live music-oriented, from curating the set list, to mixing, to pre-recording, to making sure everybody's vocals are cool and in sync. Everything that has to do with music, man, it falls on me as a musical director. And this is my 4th time being a part of the Super Bowl, 3rd time being a part of the halftime. I was blessed to do Justin Timberlake 2018. I then did Shakira and J-Lo 2020, which was super huge for Latin culture. And so excited for this one, man. This is gonna really, really break some barriers and knock down some walls. And this is really big for the culture, really big for hip hop. I work with Dr. Dre now for the last 10 years. We did Coachella 2012. And ever since then, man, we've had an incredible relationship. And I'm grateful that he trusts me with his sound. You know what I'm saying? And that's gonna keep me pushing for sure. My job is to create a song list. Dre knew the songs that he wanted to do, but then he trusted me to kind of put everybody else's set together. And to squeeze that in with one artist in 13 minutes is already a task. But now I have 5 artists to concentrate on, and so the time is split. Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, Eminem, Kendrick Lamar, Mary J. Blige. I think my first sketch might have been 16 or 17 minutes, and then I get to try to show each artist, hey, you like this? Cool, but we're over time. Where would you want to cut? After about 7, 8, 9 sketches, it got signed off on as far as the songs, and then from there, we've been tweaking. We're on version 18 of our set list. I think that it still might be going with tweaks here and there. It was very difficult for me to get down to 13 minutes. Dre texted me after the first rehearsal and was like, man, I got goosebumps. Like, you know, this is gonna be epic. And Kendrick, very similar vibes and feelings. And so I'm seeing Mary J. Blige this week. I'm seeing Marshall Mathers this week.
and Snoop as well. So I'm hoping that they give the same sentiment.
Hey. Are you at the you at the gig yet?
Almost leaving the hotel.
Yeah, the one thing I want to talk about is, so you know, it looks like the phone gag is gone. I'll confirm it with Dre tomorrow, but the phone gag is gone. And he's just gonna, you heard the track, how it goes from Kendrick to M and back.
Yep.
I guess the look is Dre is in the studio and he's like, he's controlling that. So it's a little bit more studio, a little bit more of the studio look. So I think that'll be cool. All right. See you later. Thanks. Bye. Some of the shows that we've produced at Jesse Collins Entertainment, we've done the BET Awards. I've been on the Grammys for over 15 years. But last year was my first time doing the Super Bowl halftime show. And it went well because I get to come back. You never know. So it's always special. I remember when Dre and Snoop first came out. The culture exploded. We loved it. It was a whole new sound in hip hop. So for me to now reconnect on this moment is something I'll never forget.
Hey, what's happening?
I heard that yesterday, and Curtis, you tell me that Dre asked for the stems and he added like a kick somewhere.
So version, an official 18 is probably coming.
Was sent out yesterday by Danny Chang on Tuesday, version 19.
19?
Correct.
Okay. You know, let's just get a final sign off from Dre and then let's just make the sign.
Rock and roll, no problem.
All right. Thanks, bro. So today I'll go by dance rehearsal. I'll see Fatima, dancers, and I know all that'll be great. And we'll just have a good creative conversation on where we are and, you know, what we got to do to execute.
Oh, my God. Hello! What up,
sir?
How you doing? You good? Which song did they do so far?
Mad City into All Right.
Same thing, the whole city go against me. Every time I'm in the street, I say, yeah, 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 yeah.
Fatima Robinson is so much more than a choreographer. She is a creative visionary. She is a director. Fatima figures out a way to tell a story through dance. And she's from LA. She understands what West Coast culture and hip hop is. And so she's created movement in this show that will represent that for the world.
I got the call a few months back from Dre himself, who said, you know, I'll be up here thinking a lot. And I'm like, yes, Dre. And he's like, thinking about doing the Super Bowl. And I'm like, yes. Dre and I have known each other for over 20 years. I was in the California Love video. We did the first ever hip hop tango and the Been There, Done That video. Man, Mary J and I go back so far. I did I'm Going Down with Mary, Family Affair. Snoop, oh, my Snoop. I think the first thing I did with him was Drop It Like It's Hot. It's so great working with all these artists because it does really feel like family.
Boom. My life.
Boom. Yeah. Whack, whack. But don't pick up, you're not picking up this one, just who. Whack, whack. Yeah. This Super Bowl is particularly exciting because it's in LA, in the new stadium, and having such a legend like Dr. Dre lead this body of music mm-hmm. and these artists who are all still so incredible and relevant now makes this such a special Super Bowl. And so it just feels good to see hip hop has gone from
the clubs to now Super Bowl halftime show. It's awesome. For me, Tia is my drill sergeant. She puts everything in perspective, formation, boom. She drives home your intention of your moves. Adrian is just my right-hand man.
Adrian, just quick question. Should we put a, can we just put a march on that? Did they just march into that?
Yes. Yes!
You know, Team Fatima, we really mesh so well together because we bounce ideas off of each other in the room.
It's day one, but I think it was so much anticipation of this day that today really went really well.
So
we got
good.
Super far in our choreography, further than I thought we would go. But you just keep on like hitting it.
We came in with zero choreography and we got through a lot of it because we were able to co-create and bounce off of each other's ideas.
And 5, 6, 7, 8, boom, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hello? No, okay. I mean, listen, I think the track is sitting around 1250 or 1255. So there's room to put a little breath in it. Adam's in the studio with Dre right now, so maybe we'll have a version. I'll hit him now and see if he'll have a new version before we meet tonight.
So we got that one.
This will be the third straight year that Jay-Z has had a hand in the halftime show. The result of the partnership between Jay-Z's Roc Nation and the NFL, in which Jay serves as the entertainment advisor for the halftime show.
NFL does sports, and Roc Nation knows culture. Roc Nation knows music. I think it's just a, you say L.A., what defines L.A. more than Dr. Dre and this sound and how it transcends Los Angeles even? This is hip-hop getting the platform it deserves. It's the motherfucking Eagle Double G. Snoop Dogg! You know I'm hopping with the D.R.E.
So part of the creative process, a lot of the artists went in the studio and they recorded vocals, and that gives them a chance to practice, and it gives us a chance to rehearse without having them have to sing out or rap through every pass. Sometimes we can just play the vocal and let them lip a rehearsal the rest vocal chords. So the fact that the artists are willing to go in for this and lay vocals down helps all of us.
What up?
What up?
Oh, girl.
How you doing, Adam?
Great. How you been?
Doing good.
That's good. You just got in town, or you been here?
Yesterday, just got here yesterday.
Oh, good. Yeah, we just gonna play this shit for you, and then, you know.
Dre was thinking of a different Mary song. I was thinking of a different Mary song. Fatima was thinking of a different Mary song. She was really the hardest for us to land on. I had to really sell what this moment was. Me being a Mary fan helped that too.
Come on, everybody, get on now. Hug and don't forget to get a crown. Mary Jack's in the spot tonight. I'ma make it feel alright. Come on, baby, just party with me. Let it loose and set your body free. Leave your situations at the door. But when you step inside, jump on the floor. Let me get, when you step inside, jump on the floor, and let me keep going from there. And when you step inside, jump on the floor. Come on, don't dance. Dance, get up, rock, let it.
wanted to dive into, you know, what the people would want. And we ended up with Family Affair and No More Drama, and I'm excited. She seemed happy as well. And Mary's another one. She said, yo, if you want me to do No More Drama, you gotta extend that joint, because I can't even get to the park unless you give me this part. And I was like, well, Mary, we don't got time. She was like, Adam, just figure it out. I was like, okay. So that Mary moment has continued to be an intense conversation based off of people having their own favorite Mary joint. And I'm grateful that Dre trusts me with his sound and to lead us into the right direction musically and sonically. No more.
So we're at Barker Hangar. This is SoFi for us for the next couple weeks. Zooms are great just to get the nuts and bolts, but to really get those special ideas, it takes everybody, I think, vibing off of each other and hearing the music and just getting into the moment of it. And people just sparking ideas and conversation, which you can only do in person.
6, 7, 8, and Dre.
Dre's coming through, that's the glitch, right?
That's the glitch mob. Then Snoop is coming through with the drill team. And then. Drill team. Now they come together right in here with a D on D. Boom. And then that's when we go upstairs with Hello.
Can we stop at that?
Yep.
So basically, Snoop does his whole verse on the roof.
Yep. Team, yeah. So it's
because they're conversing, then rapping, but they're saying da 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 da. Music and dance go hand in hand. Sometimes Fatima will ask me for the music well in advance so that she can put her vision to what it is. Sometimes she may say, "Hey, we've been rehearsing to this," and the good thing about Fatima is, she might make her own edit, you know what I'm saying? And say, check out what I did, now you just put the sauce on top of it. And that's, you know, such a genius thing. And one of my attributes is kind of like just enhancing people's vision.
Did you put that Inglewood? Did you put that in there?
No.
She challenges me, I challenge her. At the end of the day, it's a constant learning experience for me because she has such creative juices flowing through her that she sees sometimes the vision and hears the vision before it's even actually into fruition, so.
So Adam, can you build another 2 more bars in there? Great. So he goes, you know, give it up for my boy Snoop. It's the motherfucking D-R-E, do you know what I mean?
Well, I was gonna, you just said what I was actually about to say, which is reverse.
Okay.
Why don't we start with the Dre name? Da-da-da-da-da. It's the D-R-E, because right now he's saying D-O-double-G.
Okay.
So why don't I reverse it, and he can own the moment without it even having to add bars.
Okay.
Da, 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 da.
Okay.
It's the one and only D-R-E.
What's
da, 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 da. You
so
know,
fine.
Keep talking, keep talking.
What's up, so fine? We back up in this, you know.
Okay, got it. I should put that there.
Raise it up, then. Raise
it up, my boy. Got it. I see what you're saying, Adam.
Cool. Yeah. We just got to sell that to him because he's not a different lyricist type of person. So we just got to do it.
Yes.
I think he'll get it once
track,
he sees it.
He'll get used to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Now, as we've gotten into 2 weeks before the show, Adam is more important than ever because as we start to find out that, like, oh, we need another 4 bars here so somebody can get there. Oh, let's cut 2 bars here because we don't need it. All those things, that's what Adam does, and he has to do all of that on the fly and still maintain the musical integrity of the piece. All right. It was actually useful. Every time we come together, we accomplish something.
My name is Cap Spence. This is my 21st Super Bowl halftime show as staging supervisor. The person whose department is responsible for getting everything from outside the stadium onto the field, assembled mechanically, powered up with electricity and data in 5 to 7 minutes.
Cap Spence is Super Bowl halftime history. He's been on it probably longer than anybody on the crew right now. He knows how to motivate the field crew to get this done. He has his own way of doing it. It's very unique, but it works. They get it done.
All Super Bowl halftime shows have their own gravity of some sort. But this particular one, due to the size of the set and the individual pieces in the set, is significant in that they're taller, they're heavier. This is tremendously more ground cover than we've ever put out before. The structures in the middle, which we refer to as the neighborhood, consist of Dre's studio, a nightclub, Snoop's house, a hamburger place, on and on. Along the sidelines, these black pieces here, once these are parked in place, the ground cover deploys out from that towards the center from both edges, and it represents an aerial view of Compton.
Compton is Dre's home, and he carries Compton with him to this day. The show is a tribute to Compton in so many ways. The creation and the concept behind the set really sits with Ez Devlin and Dre. I don't even know how to describe Ez other than that she is an incredible visionary. But she's done everything from Grammys to Olympic ceremonies, plays. She's done everything.
With anything, and this is no different, it has to start with understanding the music, understanding where the music comes from. For me, Compton, like anywhere else, has its cultural icons, and they're ordinary things, but they've become iconic because of the people and the music that came from that place. That's how icons are formed, in people or in architecture. The influence that those streets, through Dre, through Kendrick, through many others, have had on the sound of the world's music, it's extraordinary.
Ez found some places that were significant to Dre. There are set pieces that you can find in Compton. There's Tams Burgers. There's the MLK Memorial. The Compton map is on the field. There are so many different ways that he could have gone with this show. And this is the way he chose to go. What's this shit feel like? I mean, could you see you and Dre ever doing this shit? Going back 94? Like,
nah. Cause I never had like those kind of visions. Like even like the Rolling Stones magazine and shit. Like I wasn't with all that. Cause I was like Source magazine, hood shit, like, you know, to get to that level was cool with me then. So I never really had this vision thinking it could be this big.
Today is day one of rehearsals. After months of Zooms and phone calls and looking at pictures and animatics, today was the first day that Dre got to walk in and see the vision that he's been wanting to see from day one. And he's gonna see more of it. By Sunday, it'll all be in here.
The first da-da-da-da-da, because they're filming you, they wanna say,
Adrian,
this is the one and only D-R-E. And then you throw the Snoop, da-da-da-da-da.
Where am I
saying
that?
What? At the top, Snoop says the one and only D-O-double-G. They wanna say
that crowd ain't gonna go for that.
Okay.
I don't understand what you're saying.
So watch, can we just listen to the beginning for a second?
Snoop mic is gonna be hot here too, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, maybe me.
Yeah, look. D-R-E.
Why are we saying it's the one and only D-O-double-G? Why isn't he saying that? We should keep it there.
We didn't have him up yet. We just had you there, and then he comes up a little later. Listen to it one more time.
Yeah, that sounds weird as shit, because I'm so used to weird.
I know, but Dre.
I just know what the fans like. You can't make them change their mind the night of.
Yeah, it's weird.
When you hear that, the first thing you say is,
Snoop Dogg!
Wait, through the lens. There's only one shot that we can show, right? Because it's really wide. He's over there.
Yeah,
you're over
there's
there.
Not a two
there's
shot.
There's not one shot you can show. You can cut. You can, you know, we're here to figure out the blocking.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I like the song the way it is. I don't want to change
okay.
the song.
Okay.
So I have a solution. Yeah. Once we keep it the same, Snoop Dogg,
okay.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mama with the D-R-E. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's let Dre mm-hmm. address us for those four bars. Yeah. We're going to figure that out. You know what I'm
yeah.
saying?
Mm-hmm.
And that is his throw to Snoop. So we're going to take...
When you have five artists, the biggest question is how does this show come together? Like, how are they gonna work together? How are they gonna collaborate?
Snoop Dogg.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
yeah.
So
what's
fun.
What's
up, so fun?
Yes, Raven, you're talking.
You can't just have them each rehearse their own individual piece and then just puzzle piece it together. They have to be there together working on it.
Yes. Yes.
Right
yes. Okay, okay, okay.
Okay. That's what we do.
All right.
All
right.
There's no way a five headliner show with artists of this magnitude who all could do 12 minutes on their own easily. There's no way this works without Dr. Dre.
Who's Snoop stand in?
Snoop stand, your stand in is right here.
Being the person that the other artists trust and they can look to and know that if he says this is gonna work for the show, we can all trust that.
So you'll walk through, you'll walk upstairs that are along the side, and then you're on the roof.
As co-executive producer, it's my job to really work with all of the different creatives who are involved in the show, whether it's the director, lighting, wardrobe, choreography, set design, to make sure that we can execute the vision of our artist.
It was a great first day. We saw Fatima's brilliance on display, saw the choreography, saw the movements. She's got Dre dancing.
That's the best part of this job. It's like being at an unplugged every rehearsal, every performance, but to see their chemistry, 30 years of chemistry, it's an amazing thing to watch.
Seeing Dre's comfort with everything, his excitement. Same with Snoop, seeing the two of them together. And he was happy with it.
All right.
So
that's coming
so
together.
We, yeah.
And I still got love for the streets. It's the DR.
So when the creative came back and Eminem was gonna have like a band. Me and Dre had tossed around the idea of it being maybe like an all-star band. And, you know, Dre has had his hands in so many people's career. And even for the new blood, having Kendrick and then, you know, Anderson Paak, man, just one of the most phenomenal talents. It felt right for me to have him up there, you know what I'm saying, as a Dre protege.
I got my first big break with Dr. Dre back in like 2015 with his Compton album. He invited me to the studio. He heard a song of mine called Suede, and he blasted it, turned it up, and had it running back like five times. Once he gives you this,
that's gangster. AP, that's gangster.
I knew I was on after that. I was on private jets, jewelry. Everything was different after that.
Three, four.
I grew up in Oxnard, California. It's not Los Angeles, but it was close enough. And we grew up to Dre and Snoop and Cube and Tupac, and that was everything. So it started like that. Eminem is another musical hero. When him and Dre got together, they did something unique, something that was daring. And I remember watching those videos, listening to that music. I always loved that stuff. With the drums on Lose Yourself, a lot of people might not pick up on the intro where he's rapping. The bass, the kick drum pattern, you know. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom. Do the boom, boom, boom. It's real intricate. It's not just like a simple kick drum pattern. It's got these different little variations that you have to sync up with. And that was probably the hardest part, just memorizing that.
When I saw Anderson play, I felt like he was a natural. I felt like he did his homework.
Two.
I was just giving him a few points in the studio, really just about what Dre was used to hearing, like making sure, you know, nothing changes too much, but I wanted him to give his own flavor on what that was. So I think he did that very well.
It's a very intense song, and you only got one shot, you know, so you can't miss your chance to blow. And opportunity comes once in a lifetime, yo.
NFC Championship time, 49ers at the Rams.
Rams will play at home, but Niners have dominated this matchup between these two coaches and these two teams recently.
I'm going to take Matthew Stafford over Jimmy Garoppolo.
I just think between that and the upward trend of what we've seen from the Rams, I think they go 24-21 and pull off the win at home.
You know, the Rams going to the NFC Championship, it was great for some people. Dre got very excited. He was very happy.
We're about a half hour out, huh?
My biggest fear was Dre wanting to go to the game.
Are you going to the game? I gotta be here. So I want
that trailer. That is dedication.
Absolutely. That's really cool.
When we explained that Sunday is a big rehearsal day at Barker Hangar, he said, as long as you guys get a TV there, I'm good.
Two, one, track.
We have all the buildings up for the first time today, and it really was about timing and about moving from each song and each artist for the dancers, for the artists themselves to see the run of show, essentially.
Now they rush in. Go up.
Today, this is our first time seeing all the pieces come together.
The bike is killing me.
And we knew it was going to be a bit of a train wreck. Some people weren't going to know where to go.
They shouldn't all be in a line. No, I know. I put it out.
But overall, the bones are there. Now we just have to keep rehearsing it. We get our timing down, fix little musical things, fix entrances and exits. But now that we see how it all strings together, we're making it so that it all feels connected.
Eminem. Yeah. Eminem, just come over, support.
Eminem actually called me to his room and he said, I'm having a little choreography envy. He was just like, wait, why is all this happening around me? I don't get any of that. And so I had to explain to him how all those people come rushing in on him and how they all bob their head while he's rising up. And I think his moment is gonna be one of the biggest moments of the show.
your 5 minutes to regroup, and then we're
gonna go. We were about to do another pass, and Eminem and Kendrick were like, "Don't you want to watch the last minute?" And I was like, "Oh shit, I gotta let the, we gotta let the moment be the moment." And so we all stopped. Snoop and Dre's face and Kendrick's face and everybody that's from LA, and really everybody in that room, even people with 49er jerseys, I think they became Rams fans in that moment. We all came together. And so it was an incredible thing.
The energy in our rehearsal room, you could just tell it was like, they wanted to do this for their city.
All right, here we go. Stand by, everyone. Here we go, the tracks.
Yeah, this is gonna be fun as shit. And the energy in the fucking stadium, especially now that the Rams won.
Yeah.
You happy?
Very happy. I can't wait to see it.
Man, this one, yeah.
Yes. Good night.
We're ahead in some places and behind in others. It's like we're ahead with everybody knowing what they have to do. We're behind in the details, especially the ending.
So we got the Black Diamond Drill Team from Compton, and they bring just a whole nother energy to the performance. Everything is like double time to them, and it has that bit of militant mixed with a bit of dance. They syncopate their hands with their smacks on the legs and the cat, cat, cat. I love it so much because it reminds me of when I was a young girl in the hood, dancing, making up routines on the streets with the friends. You know, we used to do all of that. Black Diamonds bring an authenticity to the performance.
My name is Celeste Harris. I'm the director of the Black Diamonds Drill Team and Drum Squad. I've been drilling since I was 5 years old, so it's in my blood. And these are my children, you know. They're amazing. The Black Diamond Drill Team is a community drill team. We started in 91. We're a family. We work together. We have fun together. We laugh together. We go through different situations together. Anytime my members need me, I'm there. Drill is basically the feeling you get in your soul when you hear beats. And you move your hands with it, your feet with it, you give it your all. Sometimes when I see some members just really get into it, I say, okay, you have the drill team Holy Ghost. Cause it's just a feeling, and when you on, it feels so good.
When I first heard that we were gonna be performing at the Super Bowl, we were at practice. It didn't really hit me. I'm still in shock.
I don't think it's gonna hit me until I'm actually, like, really finna perform at SoFi, and Snoop is walking past me. It's just, I don't know, so many, like, emotions, but it's so exciting.
By Snoop, Dr. Dre, growing up in Compton and being from our community and witnessing some of the stuff that we have seen and been through what we've been through. It's just amazing how they developed and how they grew. And being at practice and rehearsals, it's like it felt like we doing something positive. And I always tell them, every time we go perform places or whatever, you never know who might see you. So always give it your all. So to see them from the first practice all the way until now, I'm just really, really proud of all my Diamonds.
Okay, if everybody can take a seat, please. We're ready to get started. Welcome, Super Bowl 56 field team members.
In 13 days from today, the teams will return to their locker rooms and a halftime show will take place. This show is at the white hot center of the hottest media spotlight on earth. During that halftime show, each of you and your fellow field team members will move a set that is state of the art with lighting, video, sound, pyrotechnics, and all manners of dancing and shaking of the booty. This year, it's gonna be a whole nother ball game because we got big pieces and a lot of them. The amount of time to do this, first time we do it, it'll take us about an hour and a half. Last time we do it, it'll better take us 5 to 7 minutes. It's an unheard of amount of time to do something like this.
Clockwise turn.
Most of the operational and production capabilities that I have, I learned in the military. I was in the Army for 10 years. I went to Vietnam 2 times.
Well, you're right in the middle of the field, so it's either that way or this way.
And I got out of the Army. I went immediately to work for a hippie rock and roll band.
Towards me!
And it's a problem-solving process, you know, that involves people and equipment and moving stuff. In the military, they just train you to do that.
3, 2, 1, push
that way.
There's been a couple of Super Bowl halftime shows where I've said to the producers, you won't see this go on the field in 5 to 7 minutes until game day. It just won't happen. But game day, it will happen.
So today is our last day here at Barker Hangar. We've been rehearsing all week.
Drake, if you can make it here when you walk out to do that.
How many people are gonna be in here when I do that?
Three, those three guys. Yep, the same ones.
Oh, you had a problem with somebody? You had a...
No, it was always three.
Tonight, we'll have all of the artists. Dre, Snoop, Mary, M, Kendrick, Anderson Paak, they'll all be here and we'll run it through.
Obviously, don't tell anybody about our special guest.
50 Cent
is our special guest.
You know, keeping 50 a secret has been a little bit of a challenge. It means that it's, you know, we've referred to him as special guest on paperwork and we just haven't answered the question when people have asked, you know, who it is. And we just kept it on a need-to-know basis.
He's so excited, loves everybody in the performance. They all love him. He's excited to do the upside down things for us to see him actually do it. So, you know, the energy will just change with him in a building.
Definitely blowing the building on this one, right?
All
right, so. Where is young Marshall?
This Super Bowl halftime show is by far the most complex show we've ever attempted to do. Every day, every run, the show gets a little bit better. And it's like molding clay. You're making slight tweaks, slight changes. You're building it every day. So every rehearsal matters. Every time that we're able to do a run of the show, it gets a little bit better. And it's just been incredible to watch them not only collaborate, but champion each other, support each other, wrap their arms around each other. And I think that's been the most special part of the rehearsal process.
All right, everyone, this is official wrap. We can start taking apart the set.
We have all the tools to make something great. The records are right, the creative is right, the choreography is right. Now we just have to capture it. And if we capture it, we're gonna be great.
Next stop, SoFi.
SoFi Stadium, located in the city of Inglewood and home to Super Bowl 56, hailed as an architectural masterpiece. At an estimated cost of $5 billion, the 70,000-seat stadium is the most expensive in NFL history.
All the carts that have been at the hangar for the last week and a half, they were loaded onto trucks and brought over to the stadium. The way the stadium works is that it has one of the biggest, widest service levels of any stadium in the world. So the whole Super Bowl halftime stage is currently sitting underground, gets wheeled out of the tunnel for rehearsals, and it won't be leaving the building until after Super Bowl halftime ends.
Coming out of this tunnel right now. 2:23 so far. That means nothing, of course. You know, it's all about the end. Today we have additional 387 field cast, 40-something dancers, we have bicycles, we have cars, all things we have not had up to this point.
It looks incredible. Are you guys timing it?
Yeah, we're at 10 and a half right now. It was under 10 to get the cart set.
You know, there's 44,000 square feet of ground covering and 2,000 square feet of neighborhood.
And this will get more taut. It looks like the way I used to make my bed when I was 12. It didn't like have like that.
There, it didn't have the exact
there were no edges.
Squareness.
No,
to
it was like that, like.
The mattress was covered.
I think our biggest worry right now is the nodes. When the dancers are dancing, the tarp was bunching up like bed sheets. And so we can't change the choreography at this point. So we have to figure out how to make this thing work so that the dancers can do what they're supposed to do on it.
So if we had to do it right now, you see the nodes.
Yeah.
You see everything.
You see them.
We're talking about a tremendous amount of stuff to get out here on the field in a finite amount of time and get it perfect. And we just aren't there yet. Today's Sunday.
It takes 45 minutes there.
You know, our dress rehearsal is Wednesday, so we need to have it correct at that point.
Hi, the baby. Give your brother a kiss for me. Give your brother a kiss. Mwah. Daddy love you. Daddy love you.
Okay, what time is the halftime gonna be? 5:20, 5:25, 5:30? Because I wanna try to run as close to real. Okay.
This show is actually built for TV. Sometimes you're oriented one direction and sometimes you're oriented in the other direction. And there's something going on in each room. So as a viewer in the stadium, you're never going to get the full experience, really, because you're only going to be able to see one side of it. But through the lens, it'll really tell the story. I think the television helps you to piece that all together in the order that we want to play it in.
All right, everybody, let's go back to the sidelines. We're going to take 15 here, and then we're going to go again.
At the very beginning of 50 Cent, when they do the double clap,
Is it possible when all of the dancers do that? Is it possible to be more on a head to toe to capture more of the room so that you see everybody's doing this double clap?
One of my strengths as a producer is my attention to detail, and that's something that Jesse really leans on me for. So as we're watching rehearsals, that's something that I really step in on, and Hamish and I speak the same language, and I'm really able to go through every shot with him.
On Kendrick, you have all of the dancers who are kind of doing that like shotgun move. Can we get a straight on of that?
Because of my love for music and dance, I'm hyper aware of Fatima's choreography. So making sure that on those moments where there's a big move, that Hamish is covering that the way that Fatima might want it to be covered.
How you feel?
Oh, good, man. It looks even better. The only thing is on the reprise, it's so long. It feels like such a gap before the music comes back in.
No, I think he was trying to wait for Dre and Mary to hug.
Gotcha.
But look, we have control of that.
Sure.
So Hamish can call that.
There was a lot of talk about the ending shot. In rehearsals, we had them ending on the floor, but when we got here, just didn't feel dynamic enough.
At the end, give them some kind of pose, some kind of rock star thing.
Right.
They'll do that, and then we're done.
Okay. At the end, for all the artists. And so we decided to have them end on the rooftop, which was so much more dynamic.
Can Mary step just a little bit behind? Just take a couple of steps back, Mary, Shantae?
Just a little more, like right there.
Okay, these are the new poses.
Yes. Wow.
I think we fixed it.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Are you going to be here for the rehearsal?
You know what? I told them I'm not. You know why? Because I want to see it.
You want to be fresh? Oh, I love that.
You got a few hometown performers, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Today is a huge day. Today is our first full dress rehearsal. Everybody in wardrobe, loading in real time.
We're also making our backup in case anything happens on show day. Let's say all the cameras go down and you still have to show something on TV.
Yes.
You hit play on that dress rehearsal. It's time of day. It's everybody in wardrobe. It's exactly how it will be on Sunday. Yeah. And that's what goes.
Like that.
So you want that earlier?
That earlier. Like that.
Yeah. But earlier, we were waiting for the scream.
So get the lights ready.
And then hit it.
It's coming.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's a slow burn.
Get it ready. By the time the scream comes, it's chipping all over the place.
Okay.
Like that's what I'm gonna.
Mary, I just have one note.
Yeah.
Smile at the beginning. Just a little bit.
Smile?
Yeah, okay. When you do that kick, it's just like give a little, like,
Mary,
you're up there having fun.
Okay.
Because right now, it looks like you're frowning.
I
know, babe. So many people tell me to. Same.
But I'm a overcompensator.
Yes, okay. Thank you, Fraser.
Yeah, the Mary note was, when we get to No More Drama, start it simple and elegant, but as she starts getting into No More Drama and it starts getting that tempo, don't go to the strobes, but definitely pick it up. Okay, great.
Starting like this?
Yes, that's it. There's one other thing. Remember we did that cracking of the knuckles for piano?
Yeah.
Remember? You have time, milk this a little bit. Then when you play, can you look to the right a little? It'll be just nice to get that face look right there.
Okay, let me try that.
All right, thank you.
All right. Dre is so committed to this process, and it's widely known that he is a perfectionist, and he is gonna take all the time that he needs to get something right.
How we look?
Good. We're gonna be on time, trying to get the Tupac thing pushed through.
Oh, that's gonna happen tonight?
Well, Adam's got the track. I'm just trying to get it cleared. So if it doesn't happen on this pass, it'll happen at some point.
I know that was a long shot, because I just hit him with that just a couple of hours ago.
But you hit Adam Blackstone with that.
Yeah.
So right,
this would be a much better piano part than Furry Lease. You know?
Right.
This most recent change was in between Eminem and Still Dre. There's a piano interlude with the Beethoven song for Elise. And that leads into the beginning of Still Dre. Well, Dre decided he wanted to use the piano interlude from I Ain't Mad at Ya by Tupac.
Did he do it?
Yeah, that's what he said, he did it.
Yeah, I'd rather play that. Yeah.
Has been creative juices flowing this morning. What that means for me is that I am time coding and redoing a big segment of the show just to try to let him hear what is in his head.
I don't know if we've rehearsed. It'd be great if we could rehearse it. I can just act it out.
And I'm getting blasted by all departments. This is probably gonna happen all the way up until Saturday, Sunday, and of course, it's because it starts with the music, it's all on me if it goes down or if it goes up or if it goes double down. So I'm trying to hold it together, keep my composure so that all departments, I can lead by showing them my calmness, but inside I'm going crazy.
No vocals, bro. It's just a piano interlude, right?
It's just instead of da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, he wants to go da-da-da-da-da-da, bam-bam, no vocal changes.
Keep working. I'm slowing him down. I'm gonna keep going. Okay.
Football fans across the world are gearing up for game day.
And right here in Los Angeles, everything's kicking into high gear, from stadium preps to the star-studded parties. The city is buzzing with football fever as we count down to Super Bowl 56, now less than 48 hours away.
We got it on in 6:47 tonight, so I'm very happy. Just doing it over and over and over, the time just falls away like scales, almost, you know. If you're not working on speed, it just comes naturally.
All right, everyone, we're gonna go in about 3 minutes here.
Show mode, yeah.
We are here at what I'm calling the rap rehearsal, W-R-A-P. This is our last run through before you see the real thing happening on Sunday. I'm excited for what's about to happen. It's a culture changer, a music changer. We're gonna shift the world in a couple of days.
What's the deal? Seth. So there's an issue. We don't have camera one.
Can you hear me, please?
Can't press camera one.
And that's the main camera on the
That is the main, the whole show is on one.
Hamer said he had a redundant shot for that one camera. It sounds good, but he said he had a redundant shot.
So tonight, supposed to be a nice little easy, light run through, and technology had other plans.
All right, everybody, thank you for your patience. Here we go.
You know, we just had cameras that didn't come in, audio issues, all of it, one right after the other. Boom, 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 boom.
What happened?
He wants to see it up here on the screens, but we don't have that tonight, so
okay.
He's not gonna see it tonight.
Okay.
Jesse, intro video is not being shown in house game day, correct?
No, game day.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Game day.
Then,
game day.
Then why aren't we showing it now?
We're having a technical problem.
Oh.
Yeah. Right now they don't have that tape in the iMac system.
We're on a very tight schedule with the NFL tonight. We were supposed to have our first run done by 7:50, then the second run straight up at 8 and off the field at 8:15.
We have to be off the field by 8:30, so if we don't do this, we get no more chances until Sunday. But he's saying he doesn't want to do it unless he can see it, so if we can't see it, he doesn't want to do it.
Yeah, he went down to talk to Dre.
When we were out there, I was explaining the issues. Listen, screen isn't working, this isn't working. He wants it to be perfect. And then magically at that moment when I was like, you gotta run, and he's saying, I don't wanna run till it's running. And then it came on and I was like, look at that.
All right, here we go, everybody. Counting the pre-roll. Let's play the field, please.
NFL let us have our second run after all, because we really needed it. Artists needed it. We all needed to walk into the show confident. The crazy thing about tonight was, the plan was the first run, addressing notes imperfect. Second run was supposed to be the disaster run. We were going to pretend the cameras were going down and that audio was going down. We were supposed to, all of our contingencies, we had planned out the disaster run as the second pass. And we didn't have to pretend. The disaster was like, oh, no, no, y'all want a disaster? Let me show you guys what disaster can be. I'm glad that this happened tonight and we were able to work through it.
Everybody that's in here working hard for us and making this thing happen, everybody is fantastic. And thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Every single year, the Pepsi Super Bowl halftime show is the most viewed and most talked about music moment of the year. We have assembled a powerhouse lineup of stars to take the stage.
Dre, why did it have to be Dre and his super squad?
I'm not trying to be egotistical or anything like that, but who else could do this show here in L.A.?
No, no one. No.
Can I get a prediction on the game?
I gotta go with L.A., cuz it's L.A.
Okay.
What?
Los Angeles Rams Super Bowl champions.
We set up a press conference before the Super Bowl, and this is the first time publicly the talent gets to really address the media and talk about their vision for the show, what they're feeling.
The vision is to give what I do, to do what I do, just leave it all on the stage.
The press conference allows us to build that momentum, that excitement, and that anticipation for the performance.
We want to make sure everybody knows that this is one of the best halftime shows ever. Not only that, we want to inspire the kids and say, okay, maybe they can look at them and say, okay, I can get there, I can do that one day.
Well, the big game is upon us, and for the first time in almost 30 years, it's being held in Los Angeles. It will be the first Super Bowl for LA's brand new SoFi Stadium since it was completed in 2020.
The National Football League welcomes you to the Super Bowl 56th halftime show. The Pepsi Super Bowl 56 halftime show.
Super Bowl 56 Pepsi.
Okay, look at you confusing me. The National Football League welcomes you to the Pepsi Super Bowl 56th halftime show. To hear my voice introduce the halftime show for the Super Bowl, how do you bring it to life? Welcome shouldn't be taken lightly. Welcomes you. You want welcome, you know, you want to feel welcome. So I wouldn't say welcomes you. There's so many other words you can use, but when you use welcome, you want to make people feel welcome. Come on in, it's the Super Bowl.
The Super Bowl is expected to reach well over 100 million viewers.
The halftime show typically is the highest rated piece of the game. There are so few things left in culture that we share as a community. To me, that's an opportunity, a responsibility. There's just nowhere else that you're gonna feel the weight of everybody in our country at the same time, and that's just the power of the Super Bowl.
On average, let's say the Super Bowl is pulling around 100 million viewers. That means this would be 500 sold-out Madison Square Gardens at once.
About 2 hours away from one of the most epic concerts ever being forced into a football game ever. And very excited. We're calling it Dre Day here. But this is how we prepare, man. God has been good. We woke up this morning, and, you know, everybody is in their right mind and healthy, and we're very thankful to do what we do.
I'm really blessed to do what I do, play music for a living. Have the hearts and the ears of people watching these shows, and I'm having fun. I'm going to enjoy this Super Bowl for sure.
It's game day, baby!
Live in action, had to wear the Kobe jersey day, Mamba mentality. Boom, boom, boom. You know what I'm saying? I'm just excited.
To see the excitement in the neighborhood,
people like emptied their driveway and are selling parking in their
driveway. Yeah, I saw on the corner over here, this guy had a sign, 250 parking all day, and it was his driveway.
Yeah, it was his driveway,
I was like, I'm like, make your money, boo.
He's getting like four cars.
Make your money.
Y'all look so good.
I think my mom is crying right now because she just called me and she was crying. Good way though. Good tears. I'm nervous, but I'm not nervous, if that makes sense. This is a lot going through my head.
I just feel butterflies.
You feel me? Yeah, that's it.
Butterflies going through all around.
This experience is historic, and I don't know, I'm just so anxious to see him and I'm happy for him.
I just want to say that I am so happy to be here with such amazing, talented, wonderful human beings. It's been such a long journey to this place, but you guys have been so good, and I thank you so much. I really, really do. And when you're out there, from your heart, make everybody proud, and just be the amazing you that you are. You know, so many people have studied and trained and trained and trained for this moment right now. So I'm happy for you. A lot of dreams are coming true today, and I'm so happy to be a part of that. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much for letting us be part of this.
No problem.
Thank you, Cap.
Super Bowl 56 halftime show. Probably 5 minutes out. Like Tom Petty said, the waiting is the hardest part. But not much longer. Are you gonna give the word?
Hey, y'all.
Come on, cameras, let's do it, do it, do it.
The countdown started.
Game day is such a weird thing for Super Bowl because it's really the point of no return.
Show them what you got, let's go!
We've rehearsed it, it's set, and there's nothing that we can do as producers that's gonna change what's gonna happen in that moment.
3 minutes?
Everything that we've rehearsed over and over and over, now we just have to get out there and do it.
How long did it take?
Less than six. We had eight, so. Just for us. Now, I don't know about the rest, but I'm sure we beat eight. Easy.
Dre is in position.
Good luck, everybody.
I think 5 seconds before they went on, Snoop asked Dre, he was like, hey, cuz, is it la-di-da-di-da or da-di-da-di-da? And then the lights went out and the show was starting.
The National Football League welcomes you to the Pepsi Super Bowl 56 halftime show.
It's the one and only Eagle Double G.
Snoop Dogg! Y'all know what this is, but can y'all make some noise for my man Snoop Dogg?
To see Dre with a genuine look of like, wow, I can't believe we took it this far. You know, you can see a little glimpse of like little young boy from Compton that was in there with the records and messing around on the keyboards. And you see him when the riser's coming up like, hip hop, we did it.
It's the one and only D.R.E.
Dr. Dre, you little busters.
You know I'm riding with the D.O.G.G.O.G.
West Coast, make some noise. Come on, put your hands in the air. Everybody, put your hands in the air. Come on, everybody, put your hands in the air. Put your hands way up in the air.
Now let me welcome everybody to the Wild Wild West.
When Dre and Snoop were on top of the trailers, as they were about to take their bow, they put their hands up. It was like taking all of that in. It was important that it not be a peace, that it not be a year, but it be like, this is all love right here. I know that's a Fatima direction.
It all came together for the 50 Cent part of the show.
I think everybody was genuinely surprised at 50.
And you know we don't give up. It's not your birthday. You can find me in the club. Got a full of bub. Mama, I got what you need. You can eat the full of bub. I'm in the habit of sex. I ain't in the making love. So come give me a hug. You can hit me getting up. You can find me in the club.
Get on down, cause you know we got to get it from. Mary Kay's in the spot tonight, and I'ma make it feel alright. Come on, baby, just party with me.
I think the biggest moment for me was seeing all of Mary's dancers on the roof, and I was like, wow, like, this is a moment.
No more, no more.
Kendrick transition is very intense. Man, I got goosebumps.
To be honest, the music drives it so much. It's all about whether we want to ride the beat or whether we want to ride Kendrick's lyrics. Because I know Kendrick's gonna always put his Kendrick vibe to it.
One, you won't run, God got us, we gon' be all right. Huh.
We gon' be all right. We gon' be all right.
35 summers in the making, stop faking, you forget about Dre. 35 summers in the making, I'm talking in WA, all right.
Oh, God, this is beautiful.
One opportunity sees everything you ever wanted.
You can't even imagine how that feels to play in front of all these people surrounding you, just a little speck.
Come on, Anderson Paak. Come on, Anderson Paak. Hey.
He's beat, arms are heavy. He's vomit on the sweater already. Mom's spaghetti. He's nervous, but on the surface, he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he broke down. The whole crowd goes so loud. He opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's joking now. The clock's run out. Time's up. Over. Snap.
To still be able to control the audience and control that energy is just like It's unreal, man.
Better go capture this moment. Lose yourself in the music, the moment you hold.
For me, it was so important for Dre to play the piano. You know, he said, it gives me butterflies just thinking about playing in front of that many people. But I told Dre, you don't know how many young men you will affect by them seeing you play the piano the way you do.
Guess who's back?
At home a lot, cause when I frequent the spots that I'm known to rock, you hear the bass from the truck when I'm on the block. Ladies, they pay homage, but haters say Dre fell off. Our homie, the last album was the chronic. They wanna know if he still got it. They say rap shame, they wanna know how I feel about it.
You ain't up on fame.
Dr. Dre is the name, I'm ahead of my game. Pumping my leaves, still touching the beats. Still not loving police. I still rock them khakis with a dump in the crease. I still got love for the streets, repping 213. Still the beast bang, still doing my thing. Since I left, ain't too much change.
Still, I'm representing for them gangsters all across the world.
And still,
hitting them colors in them logos, girl.
And still, taking my time to perfect the beat. And I still got love for the streets.
It's the D.R.E.
It takes a lot of teamwork to deliver something great in the end. We have set such a high bar that you gotta live up to it. I thought we're spot on, because I see in their faces that everybody got the message that hip hop is part of the American culture, and you have to understand that, appreciate it, and respect it.
Being in this neighborhood, being in this stadium, being in this city, being here for halftime just, I think, gives people hope that you can succeed. You know, it doesn't matter where you're from, continue to dream.
Another one bites the dust successfully, no injuries. We were on in under 6 minutes. I come back because it's a special gift. It's a human thing.
Bro.
Music history, man.
People just keep on saying the words history. But I think what you're seeing with this reaction is it speaks to the power of what these artists have done. It speaks to the cultural relevance of their music over the years and still today. It really was, I think, eye-opening for a lot of people who don't quite understand how important hip-hop is to so many people.
Thank you.
You killed it.
It's really about doing something that shows people that it's possible. And hopefully this opens a door and creates a pipeline. Because maybe we were the first, but we won't be the last.
I mean, the feedback has been incredible.
I was so happy that we represented West Coast on such a level that is just iconic. It's so amazing, and it's just so true to my heart. Someone who grew up in LA and who just loves hip hop to death.
There's been so many great Super Bowl moments, but I think it was probably one of the biggest moments for hip hop. And Dre is one of the only people that could actually pull this off for hip hop. Everything that we come from, we brought it, and we brought it to the world to see. It was just a beautiful, beautiful day. It'll go down in history forever. We'll be right back.